Hey there. It's been a little while since I've done a video. Life got ahead of me, and summertime, we had some great weather, so the wife and I were doing a bunch of outdoor stuff. But I want to keep going with this G-develop list. So what I'm going to do today is we are going to switch over, and we are going to use these art resources. So what I've done is I've already made some assets here in order to use them. And what we're going to do is we are going to build more or less a Pac-Man type game. But what we're going to do is we're just going to make it a little prettier than Pac-Man. And we'll get started in that. So I got GDevelop already open. And I've got a new scene here. So what we're going to do is we're going to go add a new object. And what we're going to do is do a tiled sprite. And we're going to select an image. And we're going to choose a file. And what we're going to do is we are going to go into my art resources folder. Grab that canyon one. Open. And we're going to call this canyon map. Sorry, doesn't like that. Canyon map. Apply. So now we've got this tiled object, canyon map, and we're going to bring that in here. And we're going to just open that up. Scroll right out, and it's actually pretty huge, so we probably want to resize that in order to fit our screen. So what I'm going to do is edit, loading, it's taking its time, sweet time to load. We have no, here, got undo. Image size. You know what, it's going to take too long in pixel, so what we're going to do is cancel. Minimize this. Go into my art resources here. Open with Krita. All right. There we go. Then we're just simply going to go in here, resize canvas, and instead of being 6,000, we're going to go, let's just make this 1024. Oh, edit, undo. Sorry. The resize canvas in Krita is not the same as the resize in Photoshop. What you actually need to do is go to Image, Scale Image to New Size. In that, I want to go 1024. Constrain proportions. There. File. Save. Losses compression, share. Doesn't matter on an image like that. I believe it's done. Close that down. Properties. details. 1024 by 1024. Perfect. That's what we want now. All right. So now we're going to come back into GDevelop and remove, delete, delete. All right. Now we're going to add new tiled image, select an image, choose a file, canyon map, open. Okay. Canyon map. Apply. And now, as you can see, our screen is still slightly bigger. So what I'm actually going to do is change my screen settings. Edit scene variables. Oh, wait, no. Cancel. That's not what I want to do. I want to go to File. Preferences. Where is it? Sorry, I don't look for this very often. Where the heck is it? Maybe it's under project settings. Game settings. Properties. Rendering. There we go, rendering. So I want to go. What is it? 1024 by 1786. Apply. All right. Maybe it's 768. Anyway. Let's just go a little wider here. Close enough, I think. Okay, so now we have our map more or less centered. Add new object. Sprite, and we're going to go add an animation, and we're going to go add Fox, open. All right, cool. We have our Foxy, and we're going to call this Foxy. Fox one. And then we're going to go, actually we're going to call it Fox Left, add an animation, add, open. Edit the pixel, and we're just going to go flip it, save, and this one's going to be Fox 2, Fox Right, and we're going to go add an animation, and we're going to go add, Fox, open, okay, and then we're going to go edit the pixel. And we're just going to go rotate, save. We're going to call this Fox Down. Add an animation. Fox Open. Okay. Edit a pixel. save. Box up. All right. Apply. So we've got that. We'll bring Foxy on. But we're going to make Foxy smaller. Zooming in. All right, there's Foxy. Now we're going to go to the behaviors, and we're quickly going to add a behavior. And in this behavior, we are going to add top-down movement. Pardon me, quite the sneeze. We're going to add top-down movement for 8 directions. All right. Maximum speed, 200 is fine. Deceleration, 800. Acceleration, 400. We can play around with that. Rotate speed, 180. Rotate object, but I think we want to make that 0 for the rotate speed. Apply. Now, I'm quickly going to go into here. And I'm going to edit with Pascal. Well, actually, no, I'm not going to, because that should be transparent. Sorry, one last sneeze always follows up. Events. Add an event. I'm going to always start with my center, camera. Excuse me. Center camera on. X position. I'm sorry. This sneezing is very distracting to me. Cancel action. Add condition. Camera. Camera on object. Cancel. Cancel. Into the camera on object, Foxy. All right. Okay. Perfect. Now I want to go add a new event. Key pressed. And we want to go escape key pressed. Okay. Add an action. Quit the game. Okay. Let's give it a quick preview. All right, so of course I have nothing set yet. There is the acceleration, deceleration. You can see how it's picking up momentum and slowing. I am going to change that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into Foxy. First thing I'm going to do is edit. And I'm going to go to... that's not good. A lot of cleanup needs to be done. I don't know that I want to spend all that time cleaning this up right now. I may do it off camera after. Yep, cancel. So I'm going to have to clean that up afterwards. But for now, see, I had cleaned it up already, but I'd cleaned it up in Krita, and you can actually see that for whatever reason, it didn't keep it. But you can see kind of the transparency was there. So I'm not sure why that didn't transfer over with Krita. Regardless, I am going to do a little bit of... I just want to round these corners a bit. Just because I don't like sharp edges on my save, edit. It's just a kind of an OCD thing. I don't like sharp corners. I really don't know why the transparency didn't transfer over from Krita. It does almost all the time. So something was up with that. And here, I really don't want to spend too long on this, but I just want to quickly round these out about. So I was going to bring some other graphics in that I had prepped at the same time. However, I think that for efficiency, apply, sure, preview, let's just quickly preview that. Still not really transparent in those corners like it should be, but anyway, that's fine. We'll get on to what we're doing. So now what I want to do is I want to add a new object, and I'm going to go sprite, and we're going to go add, edit, and refine. 64 by 64, that's okay, we can do that. And then what I'm going to do is just go here with a little black dot. Bang, 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 bang. Save. All right. And we're just going to call this boundary. Apply. All right. Now, I'm going to go in here, behaviors, oh, cancel. I'm going to go drag this in here. And you can see the four dots. I'm going to take this way. Take this way. Take this way. Good. I'm going to drag another one in here. Take that way. So I need to slide over here. Take that all the way to there. So then I'm going to bring another one in here. Bring that one up to there. here. And we're gonna come down. To there. Bring another one in here. Here. And we're just going to bring it over a little bit more. There. I'm going to bring another one here. Right to there. I need one more across the top. Perfect. I think that covers them all. So now what I want to do is I want to go over here to events. And what I want to do is I want to go and add new event, add a condition, Foxy, and then we want to go collision. Oh, yep, collision. Still choose an object, Foxy. Oh, no. Boundary. Okay, so now we have Foxy is in a collision with boundary. Add an action. So what I want to do is I want to make it so that Foxy is pushed off of the collision. What the heck is it called now? No. What the heck? I'm trying to remember now what the action is called. Bounce. I don't want him to bounce off. I want him to stop. Separate. There we go. Separate objects. All right. So, move an object away from another object using the collision mask. Be sure to cause action a reasonable number of objects to avoid slowing the game down. So, object, I want to go boxy. Object that won't move. Boundary. Okay. Now we're going to give that a preview. Doesn't seem to work. Oh, there, that worked. Oh, wait, I bet I didn't. Yeah, okay, it works there. So what it is, it works everywhere. I did not put a boundary on that guy, so I've got to do that. All right, so that's fine. Let's go back here and slide that over. Slide that down, and we are going to go boundary here. Perfect. Perfect. All right. So, I'm just going to save here. Excellent. So now I want to change that acceleration stuff. I don't like how that works. So we're just going to go into Foxy here. And we got the acceleration at 400. I want the deceleration to be 0. Max speed to be 300. Apply. Preview. So now, now it's moving like Pac-Man. Excellent. I'm happy with that, except of course you may have noticed that Foxy's graphics are not the right way around. So something really important to know is that the very first in GDevelop, unlike other engines, he always wants to travel to the right. So basically what you want to do is you want to go edit this one, and we're gonna just flip that one this way, save. Then we're gonna go down here, edit, flip this one that way, save. Here, edit. We're going to go, which way is that way, save, and then save. All right, and then we're going to rename this. Foxy, right? Apply. Preview. Now we should have the motion right. Up is up, down. Down is down, left, oh, somehow. Got it, vertical flip, all right. No, it couldn't be perfect, right? So, the heading this way, because it's rotating, that way, so we need to, I need to flip it vertically. Flip, 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 save, apply, preview. If you didn't see what I did there real quick, to get it vertically flipping, still didn't do it. Okay. Again, I don't know why it's wanting to flip that. Oh well, that's fine. I can handle that. It's not the end of the world here. All right, so now what we need to do, add new object, sprite, add an animation, edit. And what we're going to do is we are just going to take this shape. Bang. And we're going to take a color. Let's go with the red. Fill. Then we're going to take this shape again. And then we're going to go this make? Little eye there. Little eye there. Perfect, right there. And then we're just gonna go with a line and we're gonna go. And there's our bad guy. All right, save. And we're gonna call him bad guy. All right, we got bad guy made. So now, we're going to drag him on here, and we're just going to make sure that he's on the map. We're going to hit preview, and we're going to run a little fox around the cave, the map, and there's the bad guy. It's about the right size. Perfect. I'm going to exit out of that, and then what we're going to do is we're going to have to add some animation to him, so we're going to make him move around, and add new event, add a collision, we're going to go with Foxy collides with new sprite, okay, add an action, for right now we're just going to go quit the game, all right. Preview. Boom. Perfect. Okay. So it's game over if Foxy collides. But we need to add some... Oops. I accidentally closed my Foxy scene. Okay. So now we want to go to here. We're going to go behaviors. Add a behavior. And what I am going to do is... animated back and forth movement. Sure. Distance traveled. 600. Perfect. We're going to make it a little faster. We're going to make it move 300. Apply. Preview. It didn't move. So, why didn't it move? Behaviors just traveled on x-axis in pixels. Kind of animated back and forth. Hmm. Alright. Well, I'm going to grab a different behavior. Functions and behaviors. Animated back and forth. Sign movement. Variable. Actually, you know what? I'm going to do sign movement. I can do that. Alright, let's do that instead. Behaviors. Garbage that one. Okay. Add a behavior. Come down here. I'm going to try this pathfinding one. Okay. Charge 400, max speed 200. Angle offset, angle rotate, virtual grid. I don't know what that does. I would play around with that here, but I don't want to waste your camera time. So, delete. Okay. Add a behavior. And so we're just going to come down to sign movement. I know what sign movement is. Center movement on X position 0. Center movement Y position 0. Distance amplitude movement. Alright. Horizontal speed. Preview. Whoa, okay. I may have got him going a bit fast. And a bit far. So we're going to go edit that. Behaviors. Instead of 600, we're going to take that down to 400. Horizontal speed. We're going to take that down to 150. Apply. So he's going a bit quick. We're going to take that behavior and we're going to slow him down. Let's go 50. Apply. Now, does that give Foxy enough time to make it around that brick? There we go. Yep. I can run around. Perfect. Okay. Escape. So now I'm going to go edit. Copy. Edit. Paste. Edit. Copy. And we're going to go all the way over here. Edit. Paste. And then we're going to go into him. Behaviors. And instead of horizontal speed, we're going to make that 0. And we're going to change this to 50. Horizontal distance, 0. Preview. Let's see what we got. Oh, okay. I see what happened there. All right. So, rename. Boo boo one. Add new object. Sprite. Add animation. Edit. What I need to do. Okay, and then we're gonna go here and we're gonna go. Oh. Then we're gonna go here. Boom. Fill. And we're gonna go here to yellow. And here. Pencil. All right, save. And we're going to call him Boo Boo 2. Apply. All right, and then what we're going to do is put him here. Okay, so now I just need to preview that to make sure that those guys are doing their thing. They're going too far though, so we're gonna have to edit that. Okay, behaviors, and we're gonna change that vertical distance 200, apply, and preview. Yeah, that's about right. Perfect. Okay. And now we're going to go into these guys. Oh, where am I? And we're going to go behavior, add a behavior, and we are going to add the same one, sign movement. And we are going to go horizontal speed, that's fine, horizontal distance, and we're going to go 400, do want to do is I want to change that speed a little bit. Behavior. Resistance. 50. Apply. Preview. Perfect. That's what we want. So now, they're not necessarily chasing us exactly like Pac-Man. There is follow a path, and there is random movement, and there is just bounce off. But I'm just doing this quick to show you that this is the next stage, because after this, we're going to move on to probably a tower defense game. But I just wanted to show you that. And then now I'll move up here. I don't have that, those ones dying, but... Well, there, I hit him. Okay. Behavior... I need to do deceleration here. Acceleration 100. Apply. Over here, I need to do add another event. And we're just going to copy this. Copy. Cancel. Paste. All right, and we need to name our new sprite, rename, Boo Boo 2. Perfect. Okay, so now preview, we should be able to, didn't make it. Preview. A different approach. Let's go through the middle. Whoa. Okay. So it's pretty tricky, but what we need to do now is add one more object. Sprite. Add an animation. Sprite name. Palette. Okay. Now we need to go edit a pixel. And basically, what we need to do is just draw. Coin, and we want to change this, and we're going to go with something nice. Let's go with a bright green fill. Fill, and I want the outside. Actually, yeah, that looks good. All right, now I'm going to go. Duplicate that frame. Now in frame 2, we're going to take this. What we're going to do is do this, this, and we're going to go fill this. However, we're going to take this black. There we go. We got a nice spinny line. Okay. Duplicate that. Bring that to the other side. Bang. Duplicate that. Bring that down here. There we go, that works. All right, save. Just wanted to do a quick animation there. Apply, okay. Now I'm gonna put one here, one here, one here, one here, one here, one here. One here. Here, one here, one here, one here. Come over to here. One here. One here. Come over to here. One here. And one here. Now you see how that looks. Oh. Loop. Preview. Perfect. We got our little spinny pills. Okay. Now it does nothing when we touch them yet. So what we're going to do though is we are going to go back into here and we're going to go add an event, add a condition, collision, general object, and we are going to go when Foxy collides with pellet. Alright, we're going to do two things. Action, delete the object, pellet. Okay. Now, the other thing we need to do is at the beginning, we need to go variable, value of an object variable, value of a global variable, global point. Dollar sign. Okay. Is equal to value zero. Okay. Perfect. Now we're going to come back over here to Foxy. We are going to go add a new object, add a text object, and that's fine. We're going to change the color here, and we're going to make it a nice bright yellow. Actually, a blue look good on that background. Fine, size 30, font, well, I'm not worried about the font, we'll go bold. Text is going to be score, apply, okay. Rename that into score. Okay, we got it done. All right, perfect. Now we need to come over here. And we need to come up here a little bit. Perfect. Score. We're gonna put it here. Alright, now we need to add layer. If you remember before, we made a layer and we always call it GUI. And we leave that as the very top layer. So now, we select score. We come over here and from base layer we call it GUI layer. So now we've got a score in our GUI layer. So now we add another object. And it is going to be text. And it is going to be, again, size 30. And again, color is going to be blue and bold, 0. Apply. And we're going to go rename score dollar sign. Oh, I can't do that because it's a variable. Sorry, rename score var. All right, perfect. Now we're going to drag that up here. And we're going to put that right there. And we're also going to select that as the GUI layer. All right, cool. So now we're going to come back into Foxy events and we're going to go add an action. This is on the collision, and we're going to go variable, and what we want to do is value of a global variable, value of it, of score dollar sign, choose an operator, add 10 points. Okay, now I'm going to add an action, change the text. Text of an object variable. text of an object variable. Change the text for an object variable. We're going to go scar variable. Oh, yeah. And we want the variable to be equal to... Oh, wait, no. Cancel. You don't want to change the text of an object variable. We've added the variable. We want to change the text. Score variable. And we want to go modify the text. And we want to go set to, and then the value we want is variable, global variables. And the value of a global variable, score, apply. Okay. Now let's give that a preview. So what we've done in this is we've told it when Foxy collides with the pellet, we're going to delete the pellet. We're also going to change the value of the global variable that we declared up at the top right, and we're going to add 10 to it. So every time it hits a pellet, in theory, we should, bang, I got 10 points, and then I got, yeah, let's try that again. Let's see if we can get 20 points. Bang, come back this way. Bang, there, I got 20 points. Come on, in there. Oh, Trixie. Oh, I made it. Oh. So, I made it because I avoided them by going up high. So, obviously, that's a cheat. But, there you can see. So, essentially, without any other levels, what we've done is we've made kind of a Pac-Man-y clone. Now, there is much more sophisticated AI. There's more in-depth stuff that I may get into at a later date about how to set up that AI. But I really didn't want the video to go on forever. So in this video, we just built a Pac-Man game, or Foxy game, Foxy versus the Boo-Boos. So when I do the next one, I'm going to put together, I've got another set of art that I worked on, and I'm going to put together basically a tower defense game. So I will show you how to do that, and what I'll do is I'll do that as a multi-level, and in that way I can show you how to proceed to the next level and to carry all your globals forward. That's why you use the global variables, so they carry forward from scene to scene to scene. So we'll do that in the next one, and just another tidbit, I'm going to be doing another playlist coinciding with these. These ones will be a little further and few between because I'm really working on building a 2D massive multiplayer online roleplay game using the Intersect engine. And I'm going to have a parallel playlist about that. It'll be more of a devlog. And it'll also be tutorials. I'll be doing tutorials on that because the tutorials are out there aren't very good. They kind of show you how to set up a tile set and do a few basics, and then everything else you kind of don't have, you're left on your own. You got to search for the forums and things and trial and error. So I'm going to do a series of tutorials on that engine, and that is going to be probably my heavier focus. I'll be coming back to doing more GDevelop, and I'll move on to some of the other platforms and things as I work here. And hopefully there is more content coming out soon on Game Guru Max, because they had an update today which added some more animation packs and a few things like that. So I'm just waiting for a few more things to come together. Right now it's just been some DLC content, and he's done a really good job of going over it himself, so I haven't really gotten into that. I'll see you in the next one. Thanks and bye.